Hey everybody, just wanted to make a quick video about baking vertex colors in Blender using a new feature and also the Vertex Color Master plugin and how that can improve the workflow. So the first thing we're going to cover is how you would actually set up a bake and get this data into your mesh. So once you have your mesh ready to go, you're going to go over to your Object Data Properties tab and hit the plus sign for your vertex colors panel here. And you'll need at least one vertex color layer in order to bake to, but you can also set up multiple layers here and operate your channel separately, which I've set up two here, so I can bake my RGB into one and my alpha into the other. And the Vertex Color Master tool will come in and allow us to copy data that we've baked from one layer to another, and that allows us to get our RGB and A all into one single bake. You could also again use this to separately bake your RGB and A individually and copy them into a completed combined channel or bake, which could allow for faster iteration, because if you need to rebake part of your data, like say, for example, you just need to bake the red channel. If you were to do it all in one layer, you would need to bake all of the channels again in order to preserve the data that's on them. Whereas if you have baked them separately, then you can copy and paste that information using the Vertex Color Master, and it will cut down dramatically on your bake time, especially if you are using a high vertex count mesh or high numbers of channels and things like that. So first, let's take a look at the vertex color bake result here. Again, I've got the RGB plugged into my diffuse, and if we hop over into the alpha, you can see I've got a noise texture baked in here. The R contains ambient occlusion. The G contains a curvature map. And the B contains thickness. Again, lastly, the alpha has our noise. So what this is basically doing here is we're taking our combined RGB, and in my case, I just wanted to do everything in one single bake, or as much as I could anyway. So I've got my ambient occlusion, my geometry pointiness node, and an inside ambient occlusion node hooked up to the R, G, and B of this. And you would just run this into your diffuse. If you again wanted to just bake a single layer, then you can just hook up one at a time and make sure that you have the right layer selected that you're looking to bake to. So you could have one for R, one for G, one for B, one for A, and bake to each of them separately. But we're just gonna bake to all of them together. We go over into our render properties here. We're gonna look at our diffuse color, so we have a better idea of what we're looking at. And make sure you're on cycles. Go to your bake section here. Select your bake type to diffuse and your contributions to color. And the new feature here is to target our vertex colors directly without having to use image textures, although you can bake from image textures to your vertex colors using this technique, which is really great. In this case, we're just using procedural data instead. Once you have this all selected, you can hit bake and it will bake to your active vertex color layer. Then you can plug in your next bake and change your vertex color layer . This takes a while since this meshes so many vertices, and run an additional bake. Once you've done both of your bakes, you would come over to your Vertex Color Master, or however many bakes you're doing, select the source layer that you would like to copy the data from. In this case, I would be taking the red channel from my alpha bake and pasting that over to the color bake alpha channel. And that would get all four of my channels onto a single vertex color layer. Again, you would need to repeat this process multiple times if you were baking each of your layers individually, or if you were trying to take advantage of the other options here. For example, it can do more than just copy the layers. It can also blend them. And there's a lot of potentially creative things that you could do with that. So I'll have a link to this tool in the description. And next, we're going to be talking about how you can use this data in Unreal Engine to create procedural textures. Thanks for watching.